On May 21st, 2000, Stryper fans from all over the world flocked to Parsippany, New Jersey for the first annual Stryper Expo. The Expo marked the first time the band had played live on stage together in almost 10 years. Stryper's music and the impact it had and continues to have on millions of fans around the world still exist. Stryper was the first Christian band to break through the music industry's barriers that held back bands with this type of message for many years. Perhaps more importantly, the band allowed young people to relate to a positive message through the vehicle of heavy metal. Stryper unequivocally paved the way for Christian artists. These expos are a celebration of the band's existence, the music they've created and continue to create, as well as a forum to support and promote the band members' new projects as well as other bands with a similar type of message. What you are about to see is what some are calling the best show of 2000.
My initial thoughts of the first annual Stryper Expo actually was in Puerto Rico. Mr. Rich Serpa, who you don't know it, but is actually standing right there, came and met with us at breakfast in Puerto Rico and you know, presented us with the idea of a Stryper Expo. And was really, really excited about the idea. And to be honest with you, I had never really given it any thought. Once he presented us with the idea, I thought about it more and more, and I thought, yeah, this could be something really, really fun to do and great to do. Yes, for the band, but even more so for the fans and for the people who have wanted to see the guys together again, be it performing or just hanging out.
I guess you can say I'm one of those kind of guys that's a skeptic. And I didn't really have any idea how something like that would go. To tell you honestly, didn't think it was even possible. But the promoter, Rich Serpa, presented the whole thing to us. And he seemed to pull a lot of things together, and it worked out.
The first thing that went through my mind was, how is somebody going to pull this off? Getting all four band members together, getting the people to come, it was going to be a real task.
When I first heard about the Expo, I was really kind of surprised. Rich Serpa, I believe, sent me an email and asked me if I'd be into it, and of course I said yes. I ended up on the phone with Oz, and he wanted to know how I felt, and I said, of course, let's do it.
We were all four in different directions, living in different parts of the country. It was one of those things that almost was a mission impossible, so to speak. Rich sure pulled us together.
Really, in essence, it's like the first Stryper show. We hadn't been together for 8 years, so this was a great way for me to see the guys and to do the show and to play and, of course, meet all you wonderful people that showed up. But I thought it was a great idea. I want to do a lot of them. I think it worked out great.
It's just a good time for everyone to get together and reminisce and take a step back in time, basically. And it's a good thing.
Well, then I was surprised. I finally got there, and I saw that somebody was able to actually pull this off. All four Stryper members were there. There were fans everywhere. The convention was packed. It was truly amazing.
Well, when I got there, I was pretty excited. I knew that it was going to be something worth being there for, and I was especially excited because my new band, Sin Dizzy, was going to be able to perform as well, and it would have been the first time we'd been on the East Coast for that event.
Well, my reaction, just to kind of go back, before the Expo took place, inside my mind and my heart, I didn't really know what to expect. The first thing your mind tells you is, nobody's going to show up. And, when you see so many people show up and people that are just, excited about being a part of this whole thing, it's always a blow away. It blew me away. I saw all these people supporting the band, supporting us as individuals, and it was just a great feeling. And then to see the fact that it appears that this second expo is going to be even more successful, and there's going to be a better turnout, more people interested, more people calling and wanting to be a part of it. Just again, it continues to just blow my mind, because, you know, we're talking 10 years after the fact, or close to 10 years after the fact. So, you know, there are still a lot of people out there who, you know, are interested in what Stryper's doing, what the individuals are doing, and, you know, want to support what it is that we are doing. So it's a great thing.
Being I haven't been to New Jersey in quite a while, it was rather cold. Winter time was still upon us, so a lot of rain, it was cold, and once we got to the hotel, got settled in, started meeting fans, it was a wonderful experience.
When I saw the hotel, it was a beautiful hotel. It was really cool because being there with the Sin Dizzy guys, we were all rooming together, so it was fun hanging out with John and Bobby and everybody. Had a few friends that came out as well, spent the night in our rooms, so it was more or less like almost like a camp, camp night.
The favorite part for me, being a participant in the Stryper Expo, was actually being at the rehearsal the night before the expo took place, and that was the first time that the four members of Stryper had actually been together in about 10 years playing the songs. And it was a memorable moment for me to be there, being a part of the whole thing.
The first time the band played together on stage was actually 48 hours before the show in a small rehearsal studio in northwestern New Jersey. They were hard at work and practiced well into the morning hours.
Play that again. Yeah.
Even still, after they returned to the hotel, Michael and Oz continued to practice for an acoustic performance the next day.
Start there.
Just start. Yeah, yeah. Only go do it twice. Yeah. Okay.
2, 3, 4. The day before the Expo, Stryper fans were treated to a few acoustic performances and in-store appearances by the band. The band signed autographs and Mike and Oz did a 2-song acoustic set at a local guitar store. Later on that evening, they would repeat the performance at a popular syndicated radio program called The Tour Bus.